Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel, man. It's your boy, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at the new uniform that Sentinel got, which makes him into Nimrod the Lesser. His shape looks a lot like Juggernaut, but it's only the shape, not the color and size or anything like that. But yeah, he got his uniform, which turned him into this modern guy, which looks like a lot like GBR, into this cool looking robot Nimrod with wings on his back. It's so cool. It reminded me of a toy I used to have back in the day from Transformer, if you know it. But yeah, this is such a cool uniform, and the effects are also bonkers on him. Like, his effects are 10% increase to all attack and immunity to mind blast effect, okay. And apart from that, his skills effects are so on and so forth, which makes him a very strong competitor in the PvP against mutant characters. Since, let me tell you why, because his passive increases damage dealt to mutant characters by 90% and decreases damage received from mutant characters by 50%, and he has a passive which increases attack defense of summoned characters and increases HP of himself, dominance and all that shenanigans. So he is a mutant takeout machine. So I think he can totally go toe-to-toe against some of the mutants in PvP. I don't know about PvE, which we are going to test in a bit and see how he performs there. So without any further ado, let's dive into some PvP and see what he has, PvE, and see what he has in store for us. Now, I forgot to check out his typing on the damage. So basically his damage dealing type is energy attack, so he can go against Calypsidian and Emery Maw and so on and so forth. His typing is universal, creature, neutral, super villain. He has pure evil tag and machine tag, so he is a super villain uniform, so that is cool. One more villain added to our roster, but I think what Netmarble should do is give away Sentinel for free to other players as well, because as a character, as a standalone character, Sentinel doesn't have a lot of value as of now. But if they give it away, the uniform might just make him worthwhile to purchase, right? So let's go into Ebony Maw and see what he can do against him. We for sure gonna take some strong team just to make him look a bit good, which is the purpose of this video. Now, since he is neutral, we can take his on villain side, of course. So we have to take in lead and supports which does not affect to villain and which affects the villain. So like, we're gonna take Baron Zemo for villain allies increase attack by 50%, and let's take again Mystique, because she has a support which applies to everyone in the game apparently now. So let's see how he does against Ebony Maw now. I think this should totally make him worthwhile the investment and make him a very strong character, but I have a deep down feeling that he's not that good, to be honest, because we have seen how that goes. Out of the 4 or 5 uniform that we get every update, not each of the uniform is that amazing. But anything can happen. Let's see how this one goes. Right, he has damage accumulation, debuff removal and so on and so forth, a lot of amazing skills. So let's see. I have given him a CTP of energy, so that should do some work for him in the long run. Now, he doesn't have any advantage with the team up that I have gone for, so obviously he won't have that co-op skill which would have made him so strong, so much stronger. Okay, there was a very good damage, a bar worth of damage, not that much, but still something as far as we can expect from him as a character. Okay, so let's try doing something here. Let's do some work. Sentinel. Okay, yeah, it's just as I expected, not the damage that I expect from him in PvE specific. So yeah, he is just going to be like other characters. Maybe he will be worthwhile in the squad battle, the new update that we are going to be getting in this update. Right, that game mode might make him a worthwhile. A video will be coming on it short soon, so don't worry about that. Okay, let's try doing some work here. Okay, here we go. Let's try dodging these. It's often seen that the summoning characters not do so well in PvE or some stuffs like that. So that is nothing that is new to us. Summoning characters are always tend to be weak in the game. They are pretty much Shadowland characters, to be honest. Okay. Here we go. 5, 4, 2, 3, 1. Let's do 5. Now this is a chaining damage, so nice. Let's proc down 4. Totally no damage at all. The bar didn't even flinched. Damn, it's bad. Now this damage was little good. Let's see how we can do it here. I have very little hope for this, my brother here, because he's not showing to me any signs of being strong. If a character is strong, regardless of how bad you play, he will get out some damage once in a while, right? So, but the damage in him against him is non-existent. Like, we are 3 minutes down the battle, and what progress do we have to show for it? 4 bars worth of damage. Is that enough to justify buying a uniform worth 1750 while there are a lot many uniforms that you don't even have in your roster? I don't think so. And that too for a character that we don't even own yet. Like, most of the player base must not be having Sentinel yet in their roster, right? So why to go for about buying this uniform if it doesn't serve any purpose in the game? Okay, so that is my thinking on it. I don't know about you guys. You might just go for him if you have Sentinel at tier 2 and you don't have any other uniform left to buy, because why not, right? If it makes a character better and usable, then you should definitely go for it. But apart from that, if you have better options to consider, then you can skip on him for sure. Okay, so let's peace out from here. I think that would do it for Nimrod. I would love to know what are your comments, what are your thoughts on Nimrod. Do hit me in the comment section down below. I would love to hear from you guys, and the giveaway results will be announced in this video in the end, so stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching. It's your bro HunterOnHive signing out. So guys, we are in my Jean Grey Marvel Girl uniform versus X-Men Red Uni PvP test PvE testing video, and we are going to see what are the comments down below. There were only 6 comments with 5 participants, namely Karuna Jain, Ronak Banerjee, Kavi Navan, MFF Fantasies and Debatam Das. So there was no point at going about a lottery system. So I guess these 5 are the winners. You guys get 1 crystal coupon each. Contact me via Facebook or my line ID, which I will mention in this video's description box, and you will get your coupon there. So congratulations on winning and keep participating. And for those who you all did not win or did not participate, this video is also having a giveaway where I'll pick 5 or 10 winners, totally depending upon the number of comments which I get in this video. So do make sure to comment down below to get that 300 crystal coupon for free. So with that, we come to an end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out.